A ratio is a comparison of two similar quantities in fraction form. So in ratio, okay, we always have to express two similar quantities and we have to express in fraction form. So here the ratio of two quantities x and y is written as x is to y. So when you compare x and y, okay, both are same one, similar quantity, you can write x by y in fractional form or x is to y. So we will write this as x is to y. So this is ratio of two similar quantity. So this x, okay, this is consequent. This x is called, sorry, antecedent, and y is called consequent. So this is antecedent, this is consequent. So look, note this one. Okay, we cannot find the ratio of online quantities. That means we cannot find the ratio of two dissimilar quantities. Like we cannot compare yours with your weight. Okay, yours and weight cannot be compared. You cannot compare height and weight. Okay, you have to compare either weight, okay, weight with weight only, and height with height only. So we have to compare only two similar quantities to write in the ratio form. Now we will start exercise 9.1. Okay, so question number 1 you do yourself. Question number 2, express the following ratios in the simplest form. So here, okay, you have to express the given ratio in simplest form. So here it is 63:45. First you write them in the fractional form, 63/45. Now you have to cancel it, okay? 9 sevens are 63, 9 fives are 45. So answer is 7:5. Next is 8 days is to 4 weeks. So here it is weeks. So we can convert weeks into days. We know 1 week is 7 days. So 4 weeks in 4 weeks we have 4 sevens are 28 days. So you don't have to write days now. You write 8/28. Now cancel it. 4 twos are 8. 4 sevens are 28. So this is 2:7. Now question number D is 1 hour 25 minutes and 45 minutes. So you know in 1 hour there are 60 minutes. So this is 60 minutes plus 25 minutes is 85 minutes. So 1 hour 25 minutes is 85 minutes is to 45 minutes. So no need to write minutes. You just write 85/45. Cancel it with 5. Okay, it will come 17:9. So this is your answer. Okay, now next is question number 3. Okay, express the following as ratios in the simplest form. So here also, okay, you have to express the given ratio in their simplest form. So first is 100 milliliter and 2 liter. So here one is milliliter, another is liter. So you know this one, okay, you need milliliter, centiliter, deciliter, liter, decaliter, hectoliter, kiloliter. So here you have to convert this liter into milliliter. So 1, 2, 3 steps. So 1 liter is 1000 milliliter. So your 2 liter is 2000 milliliter. So milliliter, no need to write. 100/2000. Cancel this 0, 0. Okay, then you get 1:20. So its ratio is, simplest ratio is 1:20. Now next is question number E. 1.3 kg is and 300 gram. So in kg, you just write your g. So here you have to convert this kg into gram. So this kg into gram. 1, 2, 3 steps. That means 1000. So in 1 kg, we have 1000 gram. Similarly, in 1.3 kg, we have 1300 gram. Is to 300 gram. So remove this gram, okay, write 1300/300, cancel this 0, answer is 13:3. So its simplest ratio is 13:3. Now next is question number H, rupees 4.5 and 60 paise. So you know in 1 rupee there are 100 paise, okay. So in 4.5 rupee there are 450 paise. So in place of 4.5 rupees, you write 450 paise is to 60 paise. Remove this paise, you write 450/60. Cancel 0, 0. Then cancel with 3. 3 15s are 45, 3 2s are 6. So its answer is 15:2. So similarly, you solve remaining question of question number 3. Okay, now Now next question is question number 4. Okay, replace the question mark with correct numbers to make the equivalent ratios. So here in place of question mark, you have to find the numbers, right? So here it is 4 divided by question mark is equal to 32 by 24. Now you compare this to, okay, here it is 32 and here it is 4. That means this 32 is divided by some number, okay, to get 4. So when 32 is divided by 8, you will get 4. Similarly, you have to divide 24 by 8. So here it will be 3. So 4 divided by 3 is equal to 32 divided by 24. So here in place of question mark, you will have 3. So here it is 18 to 36. So when you multiply this 18 by 2, you will get 36. Similarly, you have to multiply 4 by 2. So here you will get 8. So 18 by 4 is equal to 36 divided by 8. So in place of question mark, there will be 8. Now next is question number C. Here is 15 and here is question mark. Here is 5 and here it is 25. So when this 5 is multiplied by 5, then we will get 25. Similarly, here also you have to multiply by 5. So 15 by 5 is equal to 15 5s are 75 divided by 25. So in place of question mark, we will have 75.